JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for December the 4th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against, continued trading lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Thursday during the Asian session Friday. It gained marginally only versus the Kiwi, while it lost the most ground against the Canadian dollar, the Japanese yen, and the British pound. The weakening of the US dollar and the strengthening of the commodity-linked loonie suggest a risk-on trading environment. Nonetheless, the strengthening of the Japanese yen and the weakening of the Kiwi point otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. That said, the picture is mixed here as well, with major EU and US indices trading within a 0.5 plus minus 0.50% range. Asian stocks were also mixed and within a narrow range, with the exception being South Korea's KOSPI, which gained 1.31%. Investors' morale was negatively affected by news that Pfizer had slashed the target for the rollout of its COVID-19 vaccine due to supply chain obstacles. However, relatively optimistic headlines over a new fiscal aid in the US prevented equities from tumbling well into negative waters. The $908 billion US dollars bipartisan plan gained momentum in the Congress yesterday, with conservative lawmakers expressing their support. Last week, passing a bill before year-end looked nearly impossible, but now news and headlines point otherwise. So, combined with the likelihood of more action by the Fed at its upcoming gathering, this could prove positive for equities and other risk-linked assets in the foreseeable future. It seems, though, that now market participants took a more cautious approach, not only due to the Pfizer news, but perhaps also due to the release of the US employment report later today. Non-farm payrolls are expected to have slowed to 469,000 from 638,000 in October, while the unemployment rate is expected to have ticked down to 6.8% from 6.9%. As for wages, average hourly earnings are anticipated to have slowed to 4.2% year-over-year from 4.5%. That said, with the ADP report for the month missing its forecast and coming in at 307,000, we cannot rule out a miss in the NFPs as well. In our view, although the Congress is getting closer to passing a COVID aid bill, the Fed is unlikely to alter possible plans for more action, especially if this jobs report fails, jobs report falls short of the consensus. Now, passing the ball to the energy market, oil prices traded higher yesterday, something that may have also helped the Canadian dollar to take the first place among the G10s. Strangely, both Brent and WTI spiked higher overnight after OPEC and its allies agreed to slightly increase production by 500,000 barrels per day from January, even as they failed to reach common ground on a longer-term policy. This means that the group will now be cutting production by 7.2 million barrels per day instead of the previous 7.7 million cuts. Yesterday, we noted that given expectations of a three-month extension to the existing cuts, an increase could prove negative for oil prices. for oil prices. It seems that we were wrong. Following the rally in oil prices on the positive coronavirus vaccine headlines, some investors may have changed their minds, hoping that some producers will now support an output increase. Maybe the 500,000 barrels per day increase was not what many may have expected, and that's why oil prices gained. That's the only explanation we could think about. In any case, the OPEC Plus group will now be meeting once a month to review their plans, something that may result in a more volatile energy market going forward. For now, we expect oil prices to continue marching north, aided by the broader risk on environment. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the European trading, we get the UK construction PMI for November, which is expected to have declined to 52 from 53.1. Later in the day, apart from the US employment report for November, we also get Canada's jobs data for the month. The unemployment rate is forecast to have held steady at 8.9%, while the net change in employment is forecast to show that the economy has gained 27,500 jobs, less than October's 83,600. Although it's somewhat softer than previously reported, as we noted in the past, it is unlikely to raise speculation for Bank of Canada expanding their stimulative efforts again, especially after scaling back their QE purchases at their prior gathering. Both the US and Canadian trade balances for October are also on the agenda, and we also have three speakers on the schedule. Those are Bank of England Monetary Policy Committee member Silvana Denreiro, Chicago Fed President Charles Evans, and Fed Board Governor Michelle Bowman. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.